In today's design tips, I'm going to show you how you can avoid using the JavaScript option to create full width headers in your website using WordPress, OceanWP, and Elementor. So let's just jump into WordPress and take a look at how we can do all of that. Welcome to WPTuts, where I show you how to create beautiful WordPress websites without all the technical jargon. If this is your first time on the channel, please consider subscribing and clicking the bell icon to be notified of our weekly new content as soon as it's added to the channel. So, let's take a look at how we can avoid that horrible preload flash by using the JavaScript option inside Elementor to create full width layouts. Now, for this video, I am going to be using OceanWP as the theme. It's completely free, so if you're not using it, you'd like to try it out, I'd highly recommend it. The link is in the description below. So, let's just jump into the dashboard of WordPress and take a look at how we can do that. Before I do, I'm just going to reload this page and show you this flash that I'm talking about that kind of gets a little annoying. So, keep an eye on this header strip at the top, the large graphic, and watch what happens when I refresh the page. Do you see the flash? It's kind of going from being the sort of normal width to being forced out to the sort of full width. And it's something that's a little bit annoying, but it's easy to fix. So let's just jump over into the dashboard of WordPress, and I've got my page open already. Now what we're looking to do first of all is specify the width of the page that we're working with. Now if we take a look at the OceanWP settings under the main tab, you'll see we've got an option for content layout. If I expand that out, you can see we've got default right sidebar and so on. We also have full width and 100% full width. Now for this, we're going to use the 100% full width option. So that means it's going to get rid of any kind of margins down the side of the page, but it'll still allow us to create sort of contained pages. So once I've done that, I'm going to click on update to make sure that I've saved those changes to the actual theme itself before we jump into Elementor to start changing some of the things I need in there. So I'm going to jump into edit with Elementor. And what we need to do now is set up the way the header works, that large image at the top, to take out the JavaScript option that's being currently used. So if we take a look inside Elementor, you can see there's my header image. Everything is laid out the way we normally expect it to be. So this has been done just using that JavaScript switch. And let me just show you what I'm talking about. Let's select this top section. And you can see that under the layout, we've got stretch section using JavaScript or JS. And that's set to yes. So if I uncheck that, you're not going to see anything happen. It's all going to stay same full width. So you can see it's still full width, but that's because we've set it to 100% width in the theme. So now if I just update that page, don't need to make any more changes to that, and we can jump back over and take a look at that page in action, we'll see we no longer have that horrible flash at the beginning. So again, let's just come back over, let's refresh the page, and you'll see that flash is no longer evident. So a page now just loads with just the graphic being full width. And if we scroll down the page, you can see everything else is laid out exactly as it was before. So just to show you what I'm talking about, if I jump back into this and I'll close out of Elementor, go back to the dashboard, and I'll change the setting on there to take it out from 100% full width, put it back to full width, which is what it was originally. Update the page. Once that's done, I'll jump back over into Elementor, and we'll see what's going on inside Elementor itself. So now Elementor's loaded, you can see that it's now sitting inside the confines of the page. You can see that our header is positioned inside the actual main content area and balanced off with everything else, which I've set to be full width and so on. So you can see we can easily bypass that problem, overriding things without relying upon that JavaScript switch to still give us 100% full width without having that horrible flash at the beginning that doesn't look particularly professional and is very, very easy using OceanWP. Well, that's all I wanted to show you. It's pretty simple and straightforward. I hope it's given you an idea into how you can use this in your designs, how you can avoid that preload flash, how you can avoid using the JavaScript switch and just get full width pages. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up, smash that subscribe button and hit the bell icon to be notified every time we upload new content. And if you like what we do around here and you'd like to help support the channel, please consider using the affiliate links in the description below to purchase any of the products that we feature on this channel, Elementor, OceanWP and so on. It doesn't cost you any more money, but it does give a small percentage back to the channel to help support us and allow us to create more great content for you. As always, if you've got any comments, questions or feedback on this video, please pop those in the comments section below. Let's have a conversation about this technique and anything you'd like to see in future videos. Well, until next time, take care.